Why it is? going to join Mozambique in the knockout.
As the near close of business, there's still some business to attend to on match day 3 of the COSAFA Beach Soccer Championships. Who will close off the day with a profitable result? Who will join Southeastern hopefuls from Malawi in the semis to come from Group A, in particular host South Africa? Well, they got their campaign back on track where they come from behind 3-2 victory over the Seychelles. Stephen LaJoy and Magic Baptiste on target for the 2025 FIFA Beach Soccer World Cup host, but South Africa rallied via a contender for goal of the tournament from Ntuthuko Mbutho and strikes via Siyabonga Mkhize as well as Abongile Cuta. now tournament debutants of Saudi Arabia, the first non-African team to compete at a COSAFA event, finished off the day with a thumping 5-1 win over Malawi. Biggest at the time was the biggest victory of the day. And, well, the game also supplied us with the first hat-trick of the competition scored by Ramzi Duckman. Well, Duckman's work ensured that Saudi Arabia topped Group A. As things stand right now, it is well, Malawi that have qualified out the group after their win against the Seychelles 7-2. That sees them now on what would be 6 points, with the Seychelles well and truly out of the competition and out of the running. Saudi Arabia and South Africa into the spotlight and into the arena. One of these two sides will join Malawi into the last four. Bafana Bafana playing in front of their own home fans would love to do it in true Bafana Bafana South African style, dance to their own tunes. They are the kings of Mapiano across the world. They need to beat the drum and ensure everybody moves in unison. Squad goals, it's called. They need to score goals. Speaking of goals, interestingly, we stand on 68 overall in the tournament. 21 goals have been scored on match day three. That is the most since we've started the competition. That is, in fact, seven shy of the 2021 record of 75. But that was after 10 matches or so in that one. I don't think we'll get anywhere close to the 155 of 2022 after 16 matches. But nonetheless, it is Fanny Shange's side to take on Gustavo Silva, the Brazilian, who's carrying the hopes of a Saudi nation, Middle Eastern participation that we're looking to inspire the Middle Eastern nation. The next batch of beach soccer would be stars. Change of kit for the Saudis on the left of your screen. Well, Bafana Bafana back to their traditional green and gold shorts, led out by longtime serving captain Lowell Kinsley, a 36-year-old DB at sea. Defender, he's played pretty much every single minute of this year's tournament, and we'll be hoping to ensure that his participation and his team as well doesn't end there. We head down to pitch side for the respective national anthems of both countries. Africa, our land, Nkosi Sikelela iAfrica, God bless Africa. Well, will South Africa and be the catalyst of their own blessings in front of their own home faithful? We'll be delving into the various starting players as well as match officials. As South Africa really need a win as much as Saudi Arabia if they are to continue match officials for match 11 of this tournament. It goes to Said Rasir Hachim of Madagascar. Ritesh Law returns again. And there's the second referee. Third assistant is Angelo Almeida Gunya of Mozambique. And third reserve assistant referee. And Salazar Malodayo for South Africa. Interestingly enough, of those players you see on screen, there's only one goalkeeper. Ntutuzo Msane, fresh-faced and fresh haircut. Ntutuzo Msane, 27-year-old, leads South Africa. He's been one of their standout players. Lowell Kingsley, he gets more minutes as the team's skipper. Pio Gotle Kumete is a star player and a crucial part of the attack. On the bench is Sizwe Mkhize. Abonge Lakuta, he scored that brilliant goal that kept South African hopes alive in this tournament and got them to this particular position. And it's Mhlaba as well completes those on the bench. While for coach Gustavo Silva, his key man is Ramzi Dakman. Sits on four goals, tied with two other players for Golden Boot Award. Ali Astafa is in between the sticks, the 29-year-old goalkeeper. Khalid Mudaya is another one to keep an eye out for as he joins teammate Mubarak Al-Ghazari as well, the captain, 37-year-old, who plays for Al-Tamami. On the bench is Omar Karamesh, the youngster, the youngest player, second youngest player alongside Naif Yakal from the bench, and probably will provide a fresh vigor as well as a physical output from the bench. Walid Al-Yabi is another player to watch out for. So it's all to play for on match 11, match day 3 of the COSAFA Soccer Beach Championships. Gotta do it one more time or it will be the last time, the last dance for both of these sides, looking to join the likes of Malawi as well as Mozambique. Mozambique, they themselves running out handsome winners, 8-4 against Angola, the second match of the day, to ensure that they got a grasp of Group B. It'll be down now to Morocco, who play Tanzania, who have nothing to play for in their last game of the day, to see if they can also add to the numbers in terms of the last four remaining sides. You saw a picture of Gustavo Silva, the Brazilian, who was called in to inspire this new batch of Saudi Arabian stars who have really punched above the weight in the Saudi Cup as well. But that's something different here down in Southern Africa, down at South Beach in Durban. It's a whole different kettle of fish, and they'll be playing against a team that is desperate to perform in front of their Mensa, their people, their fans. It is the Saudis to get us underway from left to right in their chain strip of white and green. While the South Africans are in green with a touch of a gold on their pants. They attack the goals from right to left. Up top already in position is Pio Uhle Kumete, 38-year-old. Plays for Durban Beach Club. He puts pressure on the keeper already, who at least is a fierce shot. Ali Astafa, there he is. Guess he made a quick round to the barber there. Ntutuzo Msane. Spotting a cheese cop. Clean shaven. And would like to make a clean break away from this group with Bafana Bafana. Ooh, first heavy collisions, and the Saudis come up on trumps. And it is Saudi Arabia. Flag is up. No, in fact, it was a corner flag. And so the keeper is called into action. That was a good move there from Saudi Arabia. I think South Africa were caught with too many numbers on top, short at the back. And as you take it in or pick it up from the corner, clipped, beautiful chest work, composed work from Mubarak Al-Ghazari of Saudi Arabia, captain of 37 years of age, one of the eldest players in the competition, alongside the likes of Mike Balete of the Seychelles. And the likes of Martin Williams on the bench. You will see Abonge Lokuta, Sizwe Mkhize, Tutuko Mbuto. It's been a real find as well for them. You see, South Africa, when you read into the team that they selected, the team selection, one of the oldest squads here at the competition. With the likes of Malawi, with the younger team, they have made it to the semifinals. So it's experience versus youth somewhat. keep an eye out on Mubarak Adarsaru as well as Ali Almami. He's on the bench. He comes on and provides real change out of that Saudi Arabian bench. He was on target in that win against Malawi. Interestingly, at the time, it was the biggest win of the competition. But Malawi, having been those on the end of that, have now dished out an embarrassing defeat to the Seychelles 7-2 earlier in the day. Soon to come on. Kwazi Bengu. Bengu just waiting on the wings, the 26-year-old forward. Man who would know this particular area quite well. He plays for Durban Beach Club. 26-year-old forward. Talking of forward, that's exactly what Msani does. Holds it forward, but Kumete, a bit too flimsy in his physical approach. Good win there. Was napping. Kanyisani Hlela. He's had an iffy tournament. Up and down. Nice to see that the fans of Bafana Bafana have come out to watch their local heroes. We saw quite a bit of Mozambican fans out today. But they were outnumbered by Angolan fans. It was red during match two, but they were left red-faced after an 8-4 defeat to see Mozambique book qualification into the last four. Speaking of four, picking it up for Saudi Arabia, Ahmed Al-Hamami. I mentioned him. Watch out for his impact. Takes a tumble right in front of the official to this near side. Msani hasn't scored in the tournament as yet. Maybe serves me correctly. I don't think a keeper has scored from open play. It's all been outfield players. That's what they're in the team for. Kinsley, very strong player. Oh, they're watching on. The very proud nation of Mozambique. Job done for them. It's Mudaya. He finds Msani. Quick release from Msani. Watch out for his releases with that almost underhand style of his. It's a characteristic of his goalkeeping style. Back with Khalid Mudaya. Plays for Arsemaya. Mudaya on the floor. Ball in the air. Missed. That's a very good move there from Saudi Arabia. They've started better than the South Africans, but we have seen this with the local side. Not the best of starters. I think they're good finishers. They resemble almost an 800-meter runner. It has that killer kick at the end around the bend. The last 60, last 70, last 40. You know the rest. Control by Al-Hamami. Makes the run, Al-Hamami heads it back into the dangerous area. Good block by Captain Kinsey. Read the danger so well there that Lowell Kinsey, 36 years young. Skipped by Hlela. All he does is relinquish position and possession. Caught under the feet of Islam Saraj. They are the masters of slowing down the game and garnering fouls. That will be a dynamic of the game when you play the Saudis. And there'll be something the coach Fanny Shange will tell them. Don't give away needless fouls. They will con you into giving away set pieces. Not much really in that. I mean, it's a contact sport, and Kinsey would be hard-pressed not to at least make some sort of contact with his attacker, which Islam Saraj exploited. Signing with a little smirk. Saraj hasn't scored in the tournament as yet. Another one from the Aslamiya collective. A number of players are from there. The likes of Khalid Mudaya, Karamash, Al-Yobi. But it is the 34-year-old forward, Saraj, against South Africa's hope. Itembele South Africa, Mtutuzo Msani. Saraj Msani. It's Msani who comes up top. Does what he does best. And let's deny opposition teams. Comes out, though. Almost made a mistake. Miscalculation from Mtutuzo Msani Ndu on the attack. South Africa, can he get the pass away to Mkhize, who was open? But unfortunately, Abongile Kuta just couldn't move it to the left hand side. Chance missed by Middle Eastern side. Back with Saraj, back to goal. Liu with the power of Kinsey touches him up, and the ball decides, or rather, the team decides to go with the ball. But back to keeper Ali Al-Safar. Kuta. Yeah. That was the smallest of touches. Need to be stronger there, Al-Hamami. I mentioned that the Saudi Arabians are quite well-versed in getting little fouls that possibly aren't even fouls. It's Kingsley. He will not take a step backwards, Kingsley. Built off stern stuff, Lowell. Plays for DBSC alongside Siyabonga Mkhize. Both currently on the pitch. Three men in the line for the Saudis. Who's up top for them as the sun slightly breaks through? And just past the 22-3 here. Oof, just wide. The best chances falling to Saraj and Cole. South Africa yet to really make an impact in this game. Two subs about to come on. Aldasri, the captain. It's another incoming shot. Karamash is on as well. 21-year-old. Forward to Siyabonga Mkhize. 4 minutes now remaining in this first quarter. Remember, semi-final berth on the line here for both these teams. On 3 points apiece. The bottom of the screen, the Saudi subs. Primed and ready to come on. Primed to pounce was Abongile Kuta. From that pass, they come back again. It's Kuta against Al-Safar. It's the Saudi keeper that comes tops. Cheered every time they break the lines of Saudi Arabia. Of course, sides as well really will be keen to sharpen up their squads as well as their tactics. Just come on, that man. Ntutuko Mbuto. He's got a spectacular goal. Oh, that's a great save. Low to his right for Msane. Yeah, prior to the 2025 FIFA Beach Soccer World Cup next year. There will be the 2024 Beach Soccer Africa Cup of Nations to be staged in Egypt later this year. Really bringing to the fore, to the spotlight, out from the shadows and into the spotlight, beach soccer around the continent. And referee Saeed Hashim awards a free kick in favor of Saudi Arabia. Msani, a picture of concentration. We saw a Saraj fail from a similar position. Can Captain Mubarak Adosalri get some change out of Msani? Just over 2.5 minutes remaining. It's Mubarak Adosalri. Oh, he scores! Msane spread himself fully, but couldn't get there. And it is a goal for Mubarak Al-Asari. The Saudis are up and running. Key goal that. He scored their seventh of the tournament, courtesy of the captain. His second. Saudis first, barely a smile from Gustavo Da Silva. Yeah, South Africans. If you look at their tournament in total, the first periods, they are probably the worst of all the teams that we've seen, conceded in every game that they've played in the first period and then have to come back in the second or even leave it as late as the third, they cannot buck that trend, it seems. That's something Fanny Mshange and his side will have to work on. It's a real Achilles heel for them. Good play. Can he get the pass away? Karamash was interested. Back to Ali Al-Safa. Khalid Mudaya almost gets dispossessed by Abongile Kuta. And Karamash acrobatically tries to keep that in. Msani. South African fans need to inspire their home side here. You can hear a bit of singing ever so faintly coming out from the terraces, but I think a goal will see the imaginary roof blown off of this, the South Beach Arena. He's trying to hit that shot close to the roof, Msani. Omar Karamash. Straight into Kanyisani Hlela. By the way, that was the 22nd goal of the day. Getting closer to that 75 mark. Now six short of 75 scored in total in the championship of 2021. It's the fourth edition in this particular tournament. And some of the South African backroom staff watching on. Off with the bib for Salam Al-Rashdi, 27-year-old forward for Aliwa. The only player who plays for that particular team out in Saudi, the only representative, Salman Al-Rashdi. Mustafa Silva calls up as well, Ahmed Al-Mami. So Al-Rashdi and Al-Mami. That's wasteful there. Into the last 47 seconds. And so the goal scorer makes his way off of the sand. Well, here's a three versus one. It's the keeper under trouble in South Africa. Under the cosh. Guess who? If not Ramzi Dagman. Fifth goal of the tournament for Ramzi Dagman. He's dangerous. I think that was his first real chance. I mentioned that the South Africans throwing too many numbers up top. Look at Kingsley saying, who do I mark? Where's my support? Wow. You'll look around and find that they got it wrong and Saudi got it right. It's two for the tournament newbies and nil for the tournament hosts. They have to do it all over again the same way they did against the Seychelles. Ran out 3-2 victors. The trailing for two periods. It's going to turn to three. Oh, Dagman almost scored his sixth. Msani does well. I don't think Al-Safa, the keeper of Saudi Arabia, has been called into a shot. Oh, that should have been a goal from Siyabonga Mkhize. He's got a knack for running into those spaces, seeing a chance to attack. And the buzzer goes. It goes from Captain Saraj. In fact, Captain Odisri, as well as Dangerman Ramzi Dagman. I see the Saudis comfortable 2-0 in that opening quarter. South Africa nowhere near it. They'll now have to turn it around in the second and possibly third period. But it's only two goals. I mean, we've seen 7-2, 8-4. The score lines today, so their teams have been foot to the pedal for today in terms of in front of goal. The South Africans are still in neutral. It's 2-0 at the halftime break. Thank you. And we're about to resume the second period of this encounter with Saudi Arabia in the pound seats. With goals from Captain Mubarak Aldasuri, as well as Ramzi Dakman, the tournament top goal scorer. There's all eyes what South Africa now can come up with. Otherwise, they're getting knocked out of the tournament if they can't find... well, two goals at least to get them level in this encounter. Maybe a third to put them in the lead to start us off. It is Kumete. People will say Kumete alongside Teller's man Siyabonga Mkhize. Look for something inventive on the right-hand side, but all Kanyisani Hlela can manages to pick out a defender, a Saudi Arabian defender. And then Saudi on the counter. Karamash's touch was slightly behind him. Looks to salvage the situation. But the young 21-year-old, I think, should have taken that first time around rather than look to bring it under his belt and then release a shot. And so starting for South Africa, it is Siyabonga Mkhize, Piwa Kuhle Kumete, and Tutuzo Msane is still in between the sticks. Now picked up by Ramzi Dakman. Casual is Ramzi Dakman. Feisty player as well. He strikes me as one of those guys, you know, the star players in teams. Oh, and a goal from South Africa. Much needed out of nothing. Pelelo Tele. Durban Beach Club forward gets the goal for South Africa to cut the deficit to just one. It was Pepelo, in fact. Tele. He gets the goal that is necessary. South Africa, by the way, that was their sixth goal of the tournament. Look at that. Ramzi Dakman, I'd mentioned it was a bit nonchalant, a bit too relaxed. Guess what? Bamba Minkunz. Pelelo Tele. Pickpockets him and moves on. Dakman. He was culpable for that goal. Tilly dallying on the ball. That's Karamash. South Africa culpable as well of a similar transgression through Kanyisani Hlela. Karamash has two for company. Msani comes out, punches. The officials say here it was being a foul there. Brings it to 23 goals for the day. If you're not happy about something. There's Angelo Nguia from Msani's right foot. Bit hit and hope there. Saudi still continuing with Ali Al-Safa so far. And between the sticks for them. By the way, South Africa, one of the few teams without a second keeper. It did so in match one, match two, and are doing so in match three as well. The only goal minder they have in their midst is Ntutuzo Msane. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Well, the teams always delve into the benches and include the second keeper as part of their plan throughout the three quarters. That's a handball. It's against Salman Al Rashdi. In as Ernest Mahlaba, the 32-year-old Pezulu FC player. As well as Pepele Lacele, who plays from the left-hand side now. Siyabonga Mkhize near the ball. Captain Lowell Kinsley. Mkhize and Kinsley seem to play the majority of the minutes for South Africa. Anyway, in this tournament, two players that Coach Shanga cannot do without. And this is why. Oof. Siyabonga Mkhize almost finding his second from distance. Mudaya, Khalid Mudaya. Ooh, missed by all and sundry. Just comes off the post. Don't know how much of it Mtutuzo Msane saw. Back again now with Ahmed Almami. Playing from the left, he did play the first half from the right. Yes, Almami! Corner, good save, low to his right, Msane. Well, that one taken quickly as well. Approaching it was Mkhize, and just on his shoulder was Omar Karamesh. Oh, there should be a chance here for South Africa. Kuta, though, just a few inches away. As Ali Al-Safa smothers that. Not much in this game. Oh, blocked. Move again. And South Africa starting the tournament off on a losing note. 4-2 loss against Malawi. The Saudi Arabians were humbled by from the Seychelles 3-1. The turn of Monday saw South Africa come back 3-2 against Seychelles in the second period in particular. Well, the Saudis far too good against Malawi, 5-1. Takman hat-trick inspiring them to the first 3 points of the competition. And this is where they find themselves now. One of these sides can progress to the semi-finals and join Malawi. Malawi almost likely end up, these are the group winners by virtue of a better goal difference, because the amount of goals that they scored against the Seychelles 7-2. Sonny misses that, but lucky for him. Siyabonga Mkhize was alert. Khalid Mudaya picks it up, and nice play by Naif Kayao. 20-year-old Mudaya. Didn't know too much about that. Mubarak Al-Dasari, the captain, did fling out a little foot that could have easily went in. Kuta scored from this angle to get South Africa back into the game against the Seychelles. Couldn't repeat the feat. I think arguably still the game of the tournament, the goal of the tournament for me, given the circumstance and the quality of execution. Kinsley, too aggressive. Says, why, ref? Ref will explain to him in Portuguese, I'm sure, and coming from Mozambique. And I don't know how good Kinsey's Portuguese is. This will be taken by Ramzi Dakman. If he bangs this in, he'll be well and truly clear of everybody. 3-6th. Give an idea of the 8 goals that Saudi Arabia have scored. He scored 5 of them. Here's Duckman. Goes low and it does beat him, Sane. Makes it six for the tournament. Somebody stop him from scoring. He can't stop scoring. He scores when he wants. That's 9 goals for Saudi Arabia in Group A and on their road to the semifinals. And it's 6 goals for that man, Duckman. Oh, Sane, no chance. Sane, no chance. This guy is deadly. Ramsey Duckman, little known Ramsey Duckman. Well, if you didn't know him, now you know him now. South Africa, the 2-goal deficit. Uta and Mkhize have to restart that again. And to the right of them is Sizwe Mkhize. And to the left is Kanyisani Hlela. And in fact, that is Tutugo Mbuto. Guta. Mutaya. Oh, good work there from Mutaya. Knew exactly where he was on the pitch and where his keeper was. Until the last 6 minutes. Duckman. Surely can't score a second hat-trick running. COSAFA now with the young Omar Karamesh. Mudaya waiting for options. Goes the low road. Does find a pass. That's very good work though from Naif Yakal. Moroccans watch on with a keen interest. They play up next against Tanzania. Oh, great work. Skillful work. Naif Yakal, I think. He was unlucky there. Should have got a foul. There's Naif Yakal. Plays for Al-Tahami. Teammate to Captain Mubarak Al-Dasari. He's 17 years his senior. Oh. An option to the left to find Mudaya. He's ignored. They go for Karamash. Takes a bit of a fall. Oh, they're so good at this. So good at this, the Saudis. Just getting these little fouls that frustrate you. Can tell by the facial expression of Kanyisani Hlela. He was conned into that, lured into it. Off his Omar Karamash. On for him is Ahmed Al-Hamami. He's still on as Ramsey Duckman. I don't think anyone can get him off. Such has been his goal scoring prowess. Duckman. Another few days we haven't seen him shout. He's a happy chappy. Here, vociferous man. From the dugout is the Brazilian Gustavo Silva. The Saudis, you see the those preparations that they had to come to the tournament. And they went out and played a couple of international friendlies out in Oman. Their beach soccer championships there. They finished third in that championship. COSAFA will handle that. Also played a friendly against Italy. And interestingly, the side in the top 25 teams in the world, you know, the Saudis, and well, they've come to show exactly that. Also, Wayne Camp at in the city of Jazan under the eye of another Brazilian, Koka Zulogovic, helping out his fellow Brazilian, Gustavo Silva, and Siraj. Missed a chance in the opening period, but lucky for him, his side were able to get 3 goals thereafter. 2 of them by Duckman, 1 by Al-Dasari. Ndaya just pips in. Siraj looked unsure. Side netting from that fierce shot from Ahmed Alhamami. It's been all Saudi Arabia in both halves, both quarters. South Africa almost as if they never got off the bus. Well, I know they weren't on the bus. They walked here from the team hotel, but wow, you get it. Al-Safa. And holding off his man. That will create a bit of space as well for Alhamami. Msani handles that though. Apart from that one shot that they had, that booked through via Sphephelo Lotsele, there's not been much really for those fans to sing home about. There's hopes of South Africa getting to the knockout stages dwindling here by the second and the minute. It's another shot over the crossbar by Walid Al-Yabi. They've managed this game so well. The tactics have been spot on, knowing when to push matches, when to defend, and which areas, most importantly, to press South Africa from. Picked up by Mudaya, takes a tumble. Oh, takes another tumble and another. Oh, Mudaya. What would a beach soccer game be without Mudaya and his theatrics? Wasn't that bad, man. On the bench, Siyabonga Mkhize. Now, let us definitively say it's a yes or no. There was contact, but he ran past the man and it was his leg that made contact with the to roll four times thereafter. Oof. I think he has a future in WWE, and Msani there almost with a mistake, taking his eye off the ball. That would have been a real killer blow for South Africa. The turn of Al-Safa. That's 43 seconds. Still no action in the Saudi Arabia goals. Anywhere near them. Mudaya. Enemy of the state one. There's Mudaya. Beautiful turn. Can he get the shot away? Msani just gets his right foot to that. Then regathers it. Releases it quickly. Nice touch by Hlela. Ernest Mahlaba with the release. He's come on as well in the pitch. I think that was for Siyabonga Mkhize to be picked up by Ntuthuko Mbutho. And that will be that for South Africa. They need two goals in the third quarter. Similar to what they had to do against the Seychelles. The mission is simple. Three goals and in the game. There was a chance there. By that man, Aldusari. Little pass as well in the mix by Salam Ashari. That got the second four. The Saudis in fine, fine form. And they were added again in terms of attacking outlet. Guess who's involved again? Ashari. Bottom of the net. Who else but Ramzi Dakman. But he was culpable as well. Gave away this ball and this goal as well for Cele. One and only goal for South Africa thus far in this game. He did it all by himself. It's not been a team effort for the attackers, for coach Fanny Shange. Mudaya, when he's not rolling around, he is a decent player. That went past everyone, including him sudden. Lucky for him, and flush off the post, so the frame of the goals. Ahmed Alhamami made a guest appearance off the bench and called him Sunny into a save. Dakman always most often than not is not too far from the action. He got his second, as there was a third for coach Gustavo Silva. Now how does that affect sort of pool standings of this group A? Malawi 6 points. Look at their goal difference, it's on three. Saudi Arabia, if you were to add this as a potential win for them, that is 6 points. And their goal difference will be quite level, in fact, with that of Malawi. So as things stand, it's Malawi and Saudi Arabia decides to qualify from Group A. Can South Africa turn it around and find three goals from somewhere? Let's find out together in the third and final period. As we restart the third and final quarter of this game, with South Africa in dire need of at least three goals to win it, to level it and push it to extra time. We've only had extra time once, and that was in the opening game. Here's a chance! Missed by Sphele Loqele. He needed that to go in. Oh. What happens if the Saudis go on the other end and score? Then we'll see perhaps heads dropping even further. The South African fans in disbelief there that their hero, with the keeper at his mercy, missed. Pick up where they left from. Through Mubarak Adesawari. Khalid Mudaya. Mudaya. Oh, Mudaya. With the attempted curler, finding Lowell Kinsey in good position. Ooh. You know what? We potentially could have top 25, or two of the top 25 sides in the world playing in this year's final, with Morocco there in 18th position, while you get the likes of Saudi Arabia rated in around the 23rd, 24th position. So those rankings definitely keeping to form, true to form and pedigree. Oof. Ramzi Dakman. He's been tournament fined. Always just sniffs out the key moments. It's the sign of top players. Can just grab the game by the scruff of the neck. And guess who's down again? Mudaya. Hey, someone needs to speak to Scorsese. If anybody wants an extra one of his movies, this guy could be it. Let's see how much contact Mudaya claims. Oof. At least said about that, the better. He's, look at that. You think Mike Tyson has just knocked him out? By the way, Mike, I'm about to fight Logan Paul soon in an exhibition match. I think Logan Paul is just going to learn why he's called Iron Mike. But that's what I thought as well, against Francis Ngannou and Anthony Joshua. Don't know much. Of course, it's going to be a big money spinner. Logan Paul, still a young man. And Mike, over 40 now. There's a real peak physical condition. There's Mike Tyson. I saw him in training. Wow, scary stuff. And then let's back to the football. South Africa need to punch above their weight to get back. He's 57 years of age, as Iron Mike. Poof, moving like he's 27. Here the Saudis moving like a unit. Not going to help. The bench is up. But the score is down. South Africa heading out of the competition as things stand. Needing two goals to Bafana Bafana. They need one now. Sooner rather than later. Taken by a goal scorer, Duckman. I don't think that was a pass more than anything. Don't think he really was going for a goal there. Back to Captain Kinsley. Quick release from Msane. Not strong enough from Mkhaba. Hacked away by Alhamami. Far, far away from goals. By the way, if you're wondering, Logan Paul is 28 years of age. Oof. COSAFA. Just taking the time, the Saudis. Decompressing the situation, the pressure. Like a valve to a wheel. Just getting the air out and making sure South Africa suffocated here. Touched Ramsey. And Duckman, though, just a toe away from punching that in the direction of Msane. Here's a chance for Kuta. Big save, COSAFA. Oof, great save. Don't know how much he knew about that, but you got it done one way or the other. See, the vice president of COSAFA enjoyed that. And then amongst the crowd that was seated there. And that being Mr. Said Ali, Said Atuman. That's that replay again. Oh, you see, he was moving to his left, anticipating the low shot to the left-hand side. But ended up being on his right shoulder. Whichever way. No mayini pause, they say. Salim Al-Shashdi, as well as Khalid Mudaya. We call him enemy number one of the state, Khalid Mudaya. Pantomime villain of note. It's to see out the last 7 minutes of this game to ensure Saudi Arabia make it to their first ever semi-final of the COSAFA Beach Soccer Championships at the first time of asking. From Madagascar, we'll have words. Said Nasir Hachim. To be picked up by Lowell Kinsey. Yet to score in the competition. As a 36-year-old captain. No better time than now when his side need it. Pushed away. And keeper COSAFA will take his time with this one. To the last six. By the way, COSAFA has played all three quarters. No minutes yet for Patel Arwali, not needed. South Africans have been misfiring. That will go out. Guta will not be able to, have to keep that to the frustration. Oh, that gentleman is urging, willing South Africa on, but it's just not happening. Like me missing out on a free buffet, not going to happen. With Mubarak Aldusari. Oh, what does Msani and co do here? Kingsley does well to hold off the interest of Salman Ahrashti. On the sidelines, can Msani Hlela to come on for the last, what, 6 minutes? Who does he replace? I think he may replace Osiabong Amkizo, perhaps even Kuta. Here's Mutaya. Going backwards rather than forwards. Going nowhere slowly. Guess that's quicksand for South Africa. A web that's been spun over them by Saudi Arabia. I think they struck me as well as a tired team, South Africa. In the game against Seychelles, they somehow found second wind. The third and fourth gear to find two goals out of nowhere to end up eventual 3-2 winners. But today, looks like it's running on reserve. The collective powers, oof, wide. Again, close but not close enough. Kanyisani Hlela with the latest shot. Cheated on by Fanny Shange. Oh, mistake at the back and what can Hlela do here? Wins it the first time. What the defender does well to win back Mubarak Aldasarai. Cele, come on for a third time, like his shirt suggests. Cele beats one, beats a second, claims of a foul. He does. It's in favor of South Africa. Needs to dust himself up and get this crucial goal for South Africa. Has not scored in the competition. In fact, has not looked like scoring at all as Kanyisani Hlela. But it is from such moments that a hero is made. Those fans really hoping against all hope. This may be the second for South Africa. And, two may turn to three and then push it to extra time. They will be thinking that, while the Saudis will be thinking, catch them on the counter, make 3-4. And then we are into the last four. Yes, Hlela. Kanyisani Hlela! White. It's not gonna happen, is it, for South Africa? I just get the sneaky suspicion. Ramzi Duckman. Gives it and then runs into an offensive position, but the keeper, Al-Safar, can't find him. Yes, Hlela again. Back for seconds. Flashes a ball across the box, but Siyabong Amkhize was caught on his heels. Duckman looks around to assess the options. South Africa very much in a race against time now. Karamash. Anyway, will do for the 21-year-old. High foot claimed by South Africa's Cele. Low key, looks for the 1-2. Lowell Kinsey. Ball will never arrive to him because it's left short. Msani hacks it away. Into the last 3 minutes. Oh, that is a foul. He was being pulled there. Ramzi Duckman with a moment. Oh, and a red card for the main man of Saudi Arabia. Denying a goal-scoring opportunity to Cele. He becomes only the second player after Abdullah of Tanzania to be sent off. Wow. High drama. I potentially could see him miss the next match. Oh, Gustavo Silva, finally. You see the real Gustavo Silva wake up. If the last attempt from South Africa was a big one from Tlela, this is monumental. It's Phelelo Cele from the penalty spot against COSAFA to bring South Africa back from the brink. He misses. Oh, he misses. And with that, I think it's hello and goodbye for South Africa, unless they can somehow again in the last 2 minutes or so find two goals. They needed that to go into at least and see it down to one and then try push it to extra time. Siyabonga Mkhize. And Cele going to atone for his earlier miss. Now with Siyabonga Mkhize. Breezes past his man, Tlela. Can he get the cross away? There are two players in green, one of them being Lowell Kingsley. You see, the South African captain thought about that pass. That's looping. That's a 50-50 pass there. Not giving the captain anything to work with. Ahmed Almami to come on. Into the last 2 minutes. Msani, first time pass. Can't find anybody. Days for desperation now for South Africa. Days for difficult. They made it extremely difficult for themselves. I think there were two clear-cut chances when they sit back and watch the tape of this match. Two clear-cut chances they could have scored. I would have got them 3-3 at least. That's been the problem. The finishing has been off. Msani. Oh, that chance was gone wide there. Gustavo Silva, pedantic. Remember, by the way, when a player does see red, it takes 2 minutes before somebody can come on. Now, finally, Naif Yakales come on to see Saudi Arabia with their full complement. South Africa couldn't take advantage of being a man up. I think Ramzi Duckman will potentially take man of the match down to the last 14 seconds. Oh, look at that. Celebrations already from Gustavo Silva and his men. And South Africa suffered defeat at the hands of tournament new boys. Saudi Arabia, they rewrite the history books and write a new chapter into the illustrious Middle Eastern history. They've conquered Southern Africa's finest in South Africa as down south. And for South Africa, heads dropped into the sand for the likes of Msani. He's an outstanding tournament. I think he can hold his head up high. The Brazilian has found some Joga Bonito magic out in Durban as he has led his side to a semi-final spot alongside Malawi out of Group A. That's the man of the match, Mudaya, interestingly enough. He takes the award. I think that's his second one in the tournament. Mr. Mudaya. I think Ramzi Duckman, maybe his red card just took him out of the running. Man, wow. South Africa. So close, yet so far. But Ramzi Duckman. It's been the Ramzi Duckman show and the tournament. His two goals enough to see the Saudis down South Africa at the South Beach. It's 3-1 at full time. Join us at 4 o'clock. It's Morocco taking on Tanzania. One more spot remaining in the semifinals.
كيف كان شعوركم؟ كيف كان رجوعكم بالمباراتين هذه؟ انتم خسرتوا المباراه.
طبعا اول مباراه كان صعبه شويه، وكان بما ان ظروف السفر والتعب ما هذه اقول انها اعذار زي كذا، لكن الحمد لله احنا تعهدنا كلاعيبه انه ما مو بس نتاهل، ان المباراه الاولى خساره تودينا النهائي وتخلينا نحقق البطوله ان شاء الله.
Thank you.
We are doing this for NBC in Saudi. They are taking it. So I just want to know, first up, how important an experience is this to come down to Africa and play at this level in this competition?
تجربة جميلة، نكسب منها خبرة بحكم ان اللعبة جديدة عندنا في السعودية. نحاول نعطي اكثر شيء عندنا، نشارك بطولة بعد بطولة، قاعد تحسن نتائجنا وان شاء الله القادم اجمل ان شاء الله.
And how have you found the level of competition so far? Below your expectations or above your expectations?
هو اساسا بالبطولة هل هو اعلى من مستوانا في البطولات الاسيوية او اقل من مستوانا؟
لا طبعا، يعني اللعب الافريقي مختلف عن اللعب الاسيوي، والستايل الافريقي ستايل مختلف جدا، مو نفس الكره الاسيويه، لعب مختلف.
And finally, obviously disappointed with his red card, and I would imagine he hopes that he can play in the semi-final. What are the team's expectations going forward into the semi-final and maybe into the final?
لا الحمد لله ما راح يأثر علينا أي شيء، فريقنا كل واحد عندنا عناصر، كل واحد يكمل الثاني، ما عندنا أي نقص، كل مباراة في رجال عندنا في الملعب بإذن الله معوضين احنا.
And finally I want to ask, how difficult is it to be competitive in a sport that's very physical during Ramadan? I would imagine it's very difficult.
وبما ان اللعبه صعبه شوي وتلعب عرمه، خصوصا انه في شهر رمضان الكريم، كيف تكون الشخص يعني يحاول انه يلعب اللعبه هذه وهي صعبه خصوصا وهو صايم يعني؟
والله شوف، احنا اول ما جينا كنا حاسبين حساب الصيام، بس مجريات المباراه تختلف، لازم مجبرين ان نفطر عشان ندي اداء كويس في الملعب، اما لو لعبنا وصايمين احنا راح نطيح من اول شوط. الحمد لله فطرنا وان شاء الله بنعوض بعد رمضان باذن الله.
شكرا، رمضان مبارك.
رمضان مبارك. شكرا.
Samba. Congratulations. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, ready for our last match of the day. Malawi are through to the semi-finals. Mozambique are through. Saudi Arabia through. Tanzania skating on a very thin ice. Morocco comfortable, but anything can happen. This is football. So the winner of this match will join Malawi, Saudi Arabia, and Mozambique on the semi-finals that are going to be played on Friday. Unfortunately, we have to say goodbye to Seychelles, South Africa, Angola, and by the looks of things, to the loser of this match.
Well, match 12 may be last but not least. There's one more position, one more, well, identity will be known in terms of who finishes off at the last four. I think it's pretty standard. Morocco get all 3 points or get anything on the board, they'll ensure that they are right in there in terms of qualification. Mozambique have done it. They are the first side from Group B to qualify following their win earlier on today. And they'll be hoping to follow suit as well. For Tanzania, it's not been the best of tournaments, not been the best of returns for Tanzanites, because they are bottom of Group B, winless and pointsless as well. But nonetheless, they can, well, cause a bit of an upset, as we have seen. There's plenty of potential for an upset. I mean, who would have seen Saudi Arabia in the performance that they put in to put themselves in a position where they have now qualified for the semi-final, seeing off South Africa not so long ago. Well, earlier on as well, we had Angola and Mozambique playing out to an 8-4 result in favor of Moz. And South Africa losing 3-1 to Coach Gustavo Silva's men, with Mozambique's win earlier in the day that secured qualification for them and sees them on 6 points. Now it's just a matter of who will be the winner of Group B between Mozambique and Morocco. That's what those fans are still sticking around to find out. Unfortunately, no South Africa in the last four. They were knocked out of the group stages in the last tournament and in the fourth edition of the COSAFA Soccer Beach Tournament. It's been a good reading as well. Knocked out in the group stages for a second tournament running for Bafana Bafana. It's the turn of the Atlas Lions, who take on the Tanzanian might. Bonifisa Joseph Bawasa's team was a real star power in the likes of Sadiq Salim Max, Ismail Gambo. But it has not really combined for them when it's mattered the most. So we're almost ready to get underway for the final match of the group stages of the COSAFA Beach Soccer 2023 Championships. Chance for fans to make their way from the beaches and get seated down onto the South Beach stands and really make it a festival, a beach festival, a soccer beach festival of note, as it's been the last couple of days. Now, in terms of, as I mentioned, how the day has transpired, Mozambique 6 points from Group B, Angola 5 points, a point shy of them, Morocco on 3. So Morocco need this win, and they need to do it in regular time to ensure they push it to 6 points. And look at that, they have a healthier goal difference. So there's a real potential for the 18th ranked side in the world to share us why they're so highly regarded. Tanzania, -2 goal difference with 0 points. While in Group A South as well, it's the likes of
the national teams of Morocco, the
teams
and Tanzania,
like those that we've seen that have put their best foot forward in the form of Malawi, that have made their way into the qualification spots, and Saudi Arabia in their first attempt, they get it right. Now it's the turn of the Atlas Lions. Can they roar to a much needed victory, or are they going to be going home with the tails in between their legs? as Tanzania will do Angola a big favor. Let's find out together as the two sides line up for match 12 and the final one for the day, starting off now with the national anthems of the respective nations. And coach Bonafisa Joseph Boasa will hope for one more time his side can rise and shine onto the South Beach. Yes, they may not have much to play for, but there's pride at stake for them. As we shortly touch base with the man at the helm in terms of officiating this one, it is the Mozambican Dicky Salvador Mushanga alongside Rose Zimba of Malawi. Louis Consist Steven Siavi of Mauritius as well form the trio to headline this one from an officiating point of view with the reserve assistant referees Malusi Mbata. As we kick off matters, we're finding out the identity of the Moroccan starting five. Yassir Abada, the 32-year-old goalkeeper from Fakon Akbidar, starts in between the sticks. Dries Kanam, the club's top scorer and danger man, he starts as well from the off. Ibrahim Abagri leads the side as the captain. Off the bench, Rashad Fozuari Jabra, as well as Minima Manar, who's one of the youngest members in the squad, plays for Univers Sportive de Casablanca. And Hercules Bias player Ibrahim Sakali, just to name a few. Well, for Bonafisa Joseph Pawasa, he's gone with the trial and tested. Sariki Salam Max makes his the third start of the competition. Mtora Nasur Hassan as well, he's been one of those that's got a lot of minutes alongside Ismail Gambo, who's played 72 minutes and counting from defensive positions on the bench. Saleh Abdullah, Ibrahim Hassan and Juma Sultan Ibrahim. Salum as well, the Latin forward, will be hoping to get some few last minutes. A few the last days here in the country of South Africa, Tanzania. Well, Morocco, with the new FIFA rankings out, they currently sit on 1021. That's 1,021 points. Sees them just slightly outside the top 17 side, just behind El Salvador, Oman, and Tahiti, as well as Argentina and United States, who complete the lower half of the top 20 sides of the Beach the Soccer World Cup rankings, or FIFA rankings. Brazil still at the top, Italy second, Portugal third. Interesting, the ladies of Spain, England, Ukraine, the top three teams on the planet. Now it's over to you, Morocco. They have to get all 3 points to usurp Angola. Otherwise, there's only two teams that are beginning out of this group, and that'll be Mozambique and Angola. Getting us on the way, it is the Atlas Lions in golden, or rather red and green. A big shot, the first time for Kanam to have a go. There was a run being made there by Adnan Oubari, and on the counter, almost catching them cold. It's Tanzania called into action early on. There's Yasir Abada. Oh man, what a couple of days of beach action it's been. Thrills and spills, highs and lows, drama. As Anur Al Abbasi has come on. Interesting, that tactic. It's been a few seconds on the clock and they've already introduced Anur Al Abbasi. That's one thing that Coach Omar Saila does. He will always look to freshen up his starting five players, whether it's goalkeeper, defender, the attackers. Doesn't waste time. Oof, threshed. That's gone wide. Yeah, this game is a crucial one for Morocco. After seeing what the likes of Mozambique put out earlier today with Malawi and Seychelles, if you just touch in base with us, hello, where you been? You missed out on a hell of a day. Over 25 goals scored just today alone. Malawi 7-2 victors against Seychelles. Angola beaten by Mozambique 8-7 in the Battle of the Portuguese Amigos. South Africa losing 3-1 to Saudi Arabia not so long ago. Seeing the South Africans knocked out of the tournament. And then this one, the Atlas Lions taking on Tanzania. Quick throw in the hands of Yasir Abada. Now with the ever-influential Ibrahim Abagli, captain of Morocco. He's played 72 minutes in the tournament. Need to register a goal, but does have two assists to his name. Watch out for how the Moroccans cleverly always use the ball. Hardly you'd see it on the sand. The ball spends the least amount of time on the sand. With the Moroccans, a bit of a dive. There was their contact. A goal in favor of Tanzania. There's referee Rose Azimba of Malawi. Gives a penalty to Tanzania. Oof, don't know how much of contact there was there. Abada asking the question. Why? Helped out by Al Abbasi. That's not the start that the Moroccans would have wanted. Let's see. The touch was good from Juma. Nah, that was a mistake there from the officials. Not much contact in there at all, if any. But Jarab Rajab Juma will step up. Angola will be rooting for Tanzania, by the way, to make sure they win. It's Juma! Blasted pass. Abba. Abada is beaten. As a Morocco now really have a mountain to climb back. Already 8 minutes on the clock, and they need a number of goals to see that they get through. No problem there from Jarouf Rajab Juma. He gets his second goal of the tournament. That's the Nkwanjuni player. Skippers in Tanzanian side as well. Man to keep an eye out for his number three. He plays on the left-hand side of this Moroccan setup. That is Driss Ghanam, much like Duckman for Saudi Arabia. Or Isaac Jakam of a side that he represents. And he is a standout player in terms of participation here. Shot of Senegalese coach Omar Sylla. Now Anour El Abassi. Abagli. And Saudi Arabia walking away with group honors in Group A alongside Malawi due to which of a better goal difference. And well, Morocco, potentially, it could be a nice little setup with Saudi Arabia, either with Angola or Morocco. Or Mozambique, then they will be doing battle against Malawi. Oh, fierce strike there, just flashed by wide though. Chance. Good block. Can't afford another goal here. Driss Ghanam. Morocco. With Al Abassi. Caught by Derek Charles Makanya. Now comes it to Sadiq Salim Max. Been a standout player. Morocco need a truckload of goals. That's what they need in this crunch tire. There's, they started up pretty well, beating Mozambique 5-2. Ghanam with a brace and Zarohi getting two as well. Here's a chance for the aforementioned Ghanam, almost getting his fourth of the campaign. Well, for Tanzania. They then began proceedings, looking to be on the front foot. And so they just held on. They were beaten on the opening day. A very tight game against Angola, which saw them lose 3-2. Good work there. Pacey play on a difficult surface. And Morocco find one so easily, quickly. I mean, El Bidari, a 30-year-old Hercules BS player, draws Meta's level. It's 1-1. That's more like it for the Moroccans. Great shot. Keeper Kanyana, no chance. That'll get their confidence up and them refocused if they won before. Oh, someone catch that somewhere in the shark tank. Kingsmead Stadium, if you know what I mean. Now picked up on the right-hand side. Want to get a second and then a third. Morocco just give themselves breathing space. Captain Yassir Abada, or goalkeeper Yassir Abada, looking for the run up top of Reza Zarawi. Picked up nicely by Kanyana. Making a fist of this to Tanzania. It's very easy to just roll down and feel sorry for yourself, given the fact that their participation pretty much null and void in terms of the semi-finals. Ooh. Don't want to make that kind of mistake. That could be in semifinal. Missing mistake that Tanzania returning for a third time to the COSAFA Beach Soccer Championship, hoping to get, or well, hoping anyway, to get one better. But in terms of the silver medal that they got with an interplay from the Atlas Lions, thinks about the shot, does Riza Zarawi. It was a successful tournament for them that they showcased their quality on the sand in 2021. Tanzania drawing 4-4 Mozambique in their group opener back then, but lost their time and penalties before beating Comoros 2-1 to finish second in the pool and earn a place in the semifinals. They then defeated a strong Angola side 5-2 in arguably the best showing of their tournament, but came unstuck against Mozambique in the deciders. They went down 3-1. So no pushovers, no slouches, like I said. I remember the year later in 2022, they were back, but won one of their three pool games and did not make their knockout rounds. Lost to Uganda 4-2 and Egypt 4-3 before a 5-2 victory over Mauritius. At least meant they were went home with a win. That's something they would want to repeat in this one. Wouldn't want to go home after coming all the way here to South Africa and missing out on points. He just missed out on a goal. Adnan Obari really should have put that away for a much deserved second. I think that goal against them has woken them up, woken the sleeping Giants. Ooh, good strike, Abada, clean with his handling. And pick it up with Amin Al Bidwari. Back to 32 old keeper Yazir Abada. Ooh. Forces a save out of Guyana. He's one of the best at doing that. This gentleman you see on screen, Yazir Abada. So good with his technique, especially with little half volleys. Comes back for a second, Adnan Obari. Unmarked, unnoticed. He remonstrating with himself as he runs off the pitch. He should have had two goals at least. Or at least one. I think the second one is a bit more difficult. I'm being harsh on him. Keeper Charles Kanyana says, anything you can do, I can do as well. Yazir Abada called into a save. Taken quickly. They will need to go to reception, hand over their room keys. Now with Juma Sultani Ibrahim. He plays his football for KMC out in Tanzania. Decent control by Jabari. Now Abagli. The two Moroccan teammates toying with Tanzania. And he drew them in away from the two ball players so that Jabari could release a shot. Was on target. Just over a minute and a half remaining in this first stanza. Loose touch from Ibrahim. Jabari again. Beautiful turn there from Zauri. Did he keep that in? Did. Exceptional work there. The ball looked at to have gone out. Oof, just missed by the captain. Fights back to get into position. Abada. Now with Jabari again. Little run to the right by the captain, Abagli. But they opt to go the other way. That's something that they do really well. They make you focus on one side while they do something else, where they build an attack in a completely different area, all through this man here, Abada. Into the last minute of this first quarter. It's Abada. Not close on that one. Of course, Morocco, they themselves are making their debut at the COSAFA Beach Soccer Champs. Bringing real big name to this tournament. Oof. Makanyana again. regulars at the Africa Beach Soccer Cup of Nations have the Atlas Lions, appearing in 9 previous editions, missing only 2 with 3 bronze medals to their name. They finished third in 2013, beating Nigeria 7-2 in the bronze medal match before back-to-back bronze medals in 2021 and 2022. Right now, they are trying to vie for a gold medal and a semi-final spot. It's 1-1, courtesy of a goal from Amin Albidari. After Tanzania opened the scoring, this was the first chance, Salum Juma. First chance, he buried it. Didn't think twice at all as Abada was beaten. That was a fortuitous penalty that they got, by the way. I think the officials got that one wrong. And then from the sublime equalizer from Amin Albidari, and this miss from Adnan Obari. He really should have put that away. It was one of the two chances that he had. And then this man, Yazir Abada, one of the most technically gifted in the tournament, and he showed why. Charles Kanyama had to stretch for that one. It's 1-1. Morocco need all 3 points. Otherwise, it's Angola that go through from this particular group. Angola and Mozambique, potentially. Let's find out over the next three quarters or two quarters of beach soccer football. A reminder, in Group B, it is Mozambique on 7 points, Angola on 5, Morocco find themselves on 3, so 3 points for Morocco sees them leapfrog Angola into the second semi-final position, as Derek Charles Kanyana comes out again for the second period. Well, in Group A, pretty much confirmed Malawi and Saudi Arabia. Seychelles and South Africa fall away. It's Morocco to defend from the second quarter. Hoping to turn some of those bronze medal finishes at the Africa Beach Soccer Cup of Nations into gold out here at the South Beach. Confident, but I don't know how confident they are, particularly against a very difficult Tanzania side. The Moroccan interesting appointing former Senegal coach Omar Saila to lead them. It was in 2022, he's been with them since. Finished second in Jan at the 2024 Tudelai Dumarahao. That was behind recently crowned world champions Brazil, top ranked side in the world. So be out for some revenge against the likes of Mozambique in terms of taking the gold medal from their clutches. Mozambique qualifying earlier today. Warming up is Awad Salum Juma. Oh, missed in the end there by Tanzanian defender Juma Sultan Ibrahim. Back with Abada. From Abara to Islam. Rather, Badir Al Krashli, the 26-year-old from Association Made BS. It's a foul on the man I speak of, Badir Al Krashli. Took a knock to His right elbow. The Omar Saila watches on intently. Crunchly, that's why he's not picked up the ball. Yeah, just barged into him and running into his path there. He just failed to give away. In the meantime, Derek Charles Kanyana getting a bit of assistance from Ibrahim. Maybe he's feeling the effects as well of a long tournament. Kanab. Tris Kanab. Letting the official know exactly what his opponent has been getting up to.
This is Derek Charles Kanyana.
Kreishli. It is Kreishli. A lot of the goals today have come from that side. Just something at how the sand is sitting there that makes it difficult for handling for goalkeepers. You know, Kreishli would have been watching on and he would have known that. Ibrahim Abagli. In shot there. Back to goal for Awad Salom Juma. On the near side. Hand it back to keeper Abara. Now with Abara, there's two options either side of him. And Kreishli, as well as the captain Abagli. Bit of ping pong between Abagli and Abara. Abara getting close and close. It is Abara. Wide to the left. She watches on intently. Abagli claims a foul. Referee says play on. Picked up here by Adnan Obari. Man who missed those two chances in the first period. Hurls it down the line. Bagley. Just patient here from Morocco. Not forcing issues, not panicking. Bagley. Chief creator to the danger man. Kanam! Keeper going one way. Oh, how they open them up with just sheer patience. Moving them around like a chessboard. Pieces on a chessboard. And then got a Kanam in a good position. Again, it's Kanam. Just got there before the two Tanzanian players. If Morocco to handsomely win this game, gonna come through that man. And what he's very good at is finding those key moments in which to re-announce himself to the fans and his opponents. Dris Kanam, he's done it all three times in this tournament. Key finishes. Adnan Obhari. Dris Kanam got a bit of a slight deflection of defender Juma Sultani Ibrahim. Yeah, that's what took the power off of it. Triple sub to come from coach Omar Saila. Good first touch and a run to the corner flag. Saleh Abdullah. Yeah, he is Saleh Abdullah, plays for JKUFC. Picked up by Obari.
Morocco 1, Tanzania 1.
Going to be crucial that third period. Nice pass. Danam turns his man, then releases the shot as Obari. Captain Abagli battles in the sand. And fouled. And fouled by Sadiq Salim Max. to the fury of Bonafice Bawasa. Did not believe there was a foul at all against his side, and so did he. Fuming as Sadiq Salim Max. To calm down, there's a game to be played here. Bagley gingerly up on his feet, the 29-year-old captain. It's in a good position. Who was that yellow card for? I think maybe somebody on the bench. May have even been Bonafisa Pawasa, the coach of Tanzania. He prepares another sub. Gives him last instructions. Derek Charles Kanyana, all eyes on him. Can he stop this incoming shot from Captain Ibrahim Abagli? Potentially could score his first, and would it be, it would be a major goal for Morocco with 7 minutes now on the clock. Yes, Abagli. Abagli straight at the keeper on the follow-up. Morocco still can't put it away through Rida Zarawi. A couple of saves there from the goalkeeper Derek Charles Kanyana. On the follow-up, not much to speak from Anur El Abbasi. Attempted the spectacular. To head it back is Ibrahim. Keeper comes out again. Kanyana has been superb here. I think the bench of Morocco is gonna win them this tie if they get it right. As we've seen them throughout the tournament, it's such firepower off the bench, but they've been kept at bay, kept at arm's length thus far by Tanzania. Focus now on defense for the Atlas Lions. A spectacular attempt by Sadiq Salam Max. Oh, again, that should have been at least more closer to goals there for an unmarked Amin El Bidwari. Oh, sensational save there from Yazir Abada. From Kanyana to Abada. Looking for Navana Haji in South Beach. From Tanzania via the goalkeeper. A second would really make Morocco very nervous here. Here they come again through Jabare. Big save Kanyana, not for the first time and probably not for the last. It's Jabari against Morocco. In fact, Kanyana versus the Atlas Lions. Jabari was the one with the latest shot there for man in maroon and green. Quick release into the path of 24-year-old Al Abbasi. Morocco have to do some defending. Need to be careful they don't foul the man. Foul goes against the Tanzanian player Abdullah Mohamed Salum. Into the... well, sarcastic laughs of Bonafice Bawasa. Crichley coming on. Let's have a closer inspection. Missed the initial one. And then the Salum, it was pulled a little bit there. I think he was pulled a little bit there. And a little bounce! A mission outside of the pitch. It's tricky for goalkeepers. That bounce is dangerous. He needed that goal with the clock winding down. It is Amin Al-Bidwari. with a goal for Morocco. That's his second. That is his second, and is not in fact Ghanam, the man who's been getting the goals for them throughout the tournament, but it's a defender in Amin Al-Badari. Look at that. Three bounces. That's like facing Mutai Muralitharan day five out in Colombo. You have no chance. Ball hitting a divot and, wow, deviating not even once but twice on his way to goal. Unfortunate there for Derek Charles Kanyane. He's done exceptionally well to keep Morocco away from his goals and away from troubling the scorers. Now it's Jabare. It's a crucial goal, that one that they got. I expect them to look to control and get the game under control and ascendancy in particular. Snapshot. Mohamed Esali want to come on. Calculated shot, but couldn't get the angles to perfection. Headed back. Was on his feet a little bit. Claims of a foul by Jabari. Takes a big hit off Salim Max's shoulder. Keeper Kanyana comes out and settles matters. Pressure on another captain, Juma. Still awaiting to come on is Asali. Juma. Wired from the captain. Jarub Rajab. Juma scored two goals in this tournament. His second coming in this one. Tanzania's first. Oh, superb work. Suhar Jabari on the left-hand side with a fine bicycle kick. But again, Kanyana, how many saves has he made? Keeping Tanzania in this game, although they are out of the tournament now by virtue of lack of points on the board. I mean, look at this for aerodynamics. Look at this for athleticism. Great work all around there. The man has just joined us, Mohamed Esali. And so has Abdullah Kadir Ali Tabab of Green River out in Tanzania. 2.5 minutes remaining. Morocco with a slender lead, but a lead nonetheless that's enough to see them leapfrog Angola into the second position in Group B as qualifiers. Stretching was Badir Al Karachli. Oh, great work. Don't know if he meant that. The Tanzanian number 8, Mtoro Nasor Hassan Kanyana, forced him to give the possession away. Abada. Always going to do that, Abada. Moment he puts it in the air for more than two touches, you know the third is banging it. He's sending one down the direction of the position keeper. Also the simplistic throw to Jabari. His attempt early on could have had Morocco feeling a little more comfortable. Well, they'd still do so. They go back to Captain Abagli. Looks up, assesses the situation, can't find any options. Abagli passes on to the left. Goes straight or just past Mohamed Esaile. Dispossessed. And soon to come on as well for Morocco. This man who started the game, Adnan Obari, a 31-year-old forward. Plays for Association Sportif Martil. Bit of ball juggling by Mtoro Nasor Hassan. It's now Rajab Juma. Still not convinced as yet. 44 seconds. We're just under that now. Smallest of leads for Morocco. One mistake and This game is going to extra time, and by virtue of that, that's going to put them already in the two-point vicinity. They're already on three, so the max that they will be able to get is only five for Morocco if they go on to win it in the extra time. Parried away, steaming in was Adnan Obari, which will leave Angola and Morocco on level on points. And the buzzer goes for the second half. Guess it's got to go down to the third to solidify that spot in that group. A B. Mozambique ahead seven. Angola on five. As things stand, Morocco would be on six. Unless Tanzania score and take them into extra time.
Also, do make it a point that you follow COSAFA in all their social media platforms in order to get updates, features, as well as the group standings.
Get ready to re-enter another potential intense quarter of football. Morocco, 12 minutes away from securing your first ever semi-final of the COSAFA Beach Soccer and Championships. Captain Juma be urging his team on just to shake up things one more time for another 12 minutes. So as things currently stand in this particular group, Mozambique after their heroics earlier today with an 8-4 victory against Angola. They were first to qualify today, which potentially then could see them joined by Morocco, who are 12 minutes away from doing so. That goes wide. Very far.
Short way of target.
Morocco would be on the top of their group. Group B, but they'll be top by virtue of a better goal difference. It goes back to that opening day win of theirs, 5-2 against Mozambique. I think that put them in good stead. So potentially, maybe Morocco and Mozambique out of group B, with group A seeing Malawi and the Saudis qualifying. So it could work like this. Look, it's an ever-changing, ever-evolving sort of Rubik's Cube. Saudi Arabia taking on Mozambique, Morocco taking on Malawi. That's potentially what it looks like. As it stands, anyway. Ooh, keeper was interested. More than just interested. He even flung himself towards that. At a Yazir Abada. Issue here for Driss Ghanam. What happened to him? Let's take it on together. That was firstly. Oof, that is not far. And I think that's why Abada was worried. Had to cover that. Ghanam and Juma have been having it. They've been going at it, Juma, the captain of Tanzania and the star striker for Morocco. Referee needs to keep a very close eye on the Mozambican Salvador Mushanga. Headed away by Ahmed Al-Badari, covered by Abada. Just one goal, enough to see. Oh my goodness, I think a red card is coming. That was the best of WWE WrestleMania, and you know Ibrahim Abagli is gonna take his time to ensure that the refs know about it. If a card is not cautioned, let's have a look at that. Oh, oh my goodness. I haven't seen that. It's the two Tanzanians taking itself out. Ismail Gambo, as well as Salim Max. Might as well call Gambo Rambo. And then Sadiq Salim Mad Max. Wow. Crazy. And I think they were lucky that they caught each other. And one of them caught the captain of Morocco. May have been curtains for them in the tournament. Finishing early with an early shower for little two transgressors. Masila. Looking, I think we still confident. The side can get it done. Abada. He's tried that a few times. And he's also hit the target, I think, two times and prior to that attempted shot. To the last 10 now. Keeper will handle that. Abada. Still taking his time. Tanzania is not biting. As they do, they always bite their time, the Moroccans. Clip to the back post, open that gap for Abagli. Just couldn't wrap his foot around that. And Mongolians one shot. Oh! Special attempt there from Derek Charles Kanyana. He had watched Abada toy with him and tease him for most of this game, and he almost hit him with a sucker punch of his own. Three Moroccan players to come on. Fresh legs, fresh minds. Zarawi, Jabari. And two of those. Ooh. No touch. I have to say, Driss Ghanam has not been at the level that we've seen in the last 2 days. Barely featured in the first two quarters and this one. Nice acrobatic attempt by Adnan Obari. And fights back and bites, snaps at the heels of his opponent. Does well to win. There's Driss Ghanam. Driss Ghanam! Off the crossbar slash post. I mentioned he's a man of moments, big moments. When his team need him the most, that's when he seems to get on the pedestal, get on his bike, and puff his chest out and provide the magic moments. That's lackadaisical there from Tanzania's Ibrahim. And captain is off in his Badir Al Krashli. Thinks about the shot. No runner there for Zarawi. I think Morocco won't care about how they end up winning this game, but they'll care about winning it. I mean, Dries Ghanam, standard on multiple occasions throughout the last 3 days. He almost provided one more time. A Ghanam time. And Coach Saila just having words with him as Morocco will take this free kick. Sure, to be taken by Amin El Bedari. Just giving the star player some food for thought.
They get 5 points and it's going to come down to goal difference. But at the moment,
yes, a Moroccan, a defender who lashes at that. But the Hercules BS player can't find the finish. 7 minutes. Still very tight, this one. You need just one instinctive moment from one of those men in yellow and blue to sink Moroccan hearts. Bedari. Picked up by Krashli. Clear pattern of how they play. Always moving the ball from right, most often than not. And then big long ball to whoever's open on the left. They create space for themselves. Oh, he's so good at that. Yassir Rabada. So good at that. Better than some strikers I've seen at this tournament. In terms of technique on the volley. Taken quickly. Missed initially by Zorai. Back to the corner taker in Krashli. Zorai looks to force matters. Charles Kanyana takes matters into his own hand and hits the post. That would have been insane. Then has to make a save as well. It's all happening in the last 2 minutes. Wow. What a tournament this has been. Been an absolute privilege to have witnessed it and seen it in real time. Some of the finest teams in Southern Africa and across the world. One from Middle East, the other from North Africa. We have Southern Eastern African participants. Man, oh man. Been outstanding. It's not done yet. Still got a semi-final and final to play in the next couple of days. 5.5. Abada. Looks as if reserve keeper Mohamed Manar won't be getting any minutes in this particular game because Abada has played all three quarters. Luring his man is Soeri Jabari. It's Abada. Thinks about the shot. Goes for a calculated pass, but his calculations are off. Manages a little smile. For once, he says, I get it wrong. In Tanzania, I haven't really provided a defensive or an offensive outlet too often. Oh, here's a chance. Was there a push there? Claims of a penalty on the onrushing Zarawi. Official says nothing to see. We move. Bonafisa Pawasa, nervous. Obari. That's a little foot pass. Good looking one. There's a spectacular attempt. Zarawi. And for the unconventional.
5 minutes for us to wrap up things around here.
4 minutes. You know what? From the 2.5 quarters that we've seen, I think man of the match for me, got to go to Derek Charles Kanyana of Tanzania. The way he's been the last line of defense and also almost snatched it and equalized matches for Tanzania. I think that just edged him. No one really has stood out up until now. Zarahawi found himself in a good position. The captain almost instinctively knowing where to find him. Not been as clinical as we've seen in days gone by of Atlas Lions. Looks like need to sharpen their teeth or claws in front of goal. This guy's also been exceptional. I think Abada, between the two keepers, you can't complain, really. Gives a chance to Abdoukadir El Tabib to come on. It's been a diminutive one. A Green River player. Abada. Thinks about that shot. Where the cops for Jabari, who is on the left-hand side. And to the right is the creative Abagli. Can't find the space and a pass as Abagli. They go back to the Amal Mogador player. Abagli. Abagli! Told you, he's another creative hub of ideas, Ibrahim Abagli. Abada. Two minutes now. Bidauri controlling the game. Abada very clever in what he does. Yes, that's what they want. They want a player in open space so they can release the shot or get a pass away. It's Ganam as well as Bidauri were lurking for any scraps. Wrestling away, Juma. With Jabari. Next a front post run is Obari and the ball goes in. No, didn't. Referee says retake it. Says retake it. That was a nervy moment there for Tanzania. Still finding issue with something. No officials. This time around it's a young lady from Malawi, Rose Zimba. Ganam. The third time of asking off the upright. Nervous times this for Morocco. You're almost there. Ganam looks tired.
Just under 2 minutes. Under 2 minutes for Tanzania to find something for a draw.
56 seconds now. Any time now, Tanzania, if you want to rewrite this script under the chapter, more drama. If not them, then who? If they need it. If not now, then when? That's the big question. Looks as if Tanzania are heading out of this year's tournament without a point, without a win. Have regressed a little bit in 2022. At least they got one win and got some points on the board in 2023 tournament. Not to be for them. Oh, that would have been one hell of a blow for Tanzania. 16 seconds. Kanyana. Nah, that's not going to do it. Now down to 8 seconds. I think that is done. Omar sideline and side have done just enough to ensure that they make it into the semi-finals of the 2023 COSAFA Beach Soccer Tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, the last four confirmed they had to fight. Man or man had they had to fight tooth and nail. Tanzania had nothing to play for outside of just real bragging rights of the fact that, you know what, there are no pushovers and confidence. The man of the match goes to Amin Al-Badari by the looks of it. So, according to our statisticians, Saudi Arabia to take on Mozambique, Morocco to take on Malawi. What a tournament it's been. By the way, touch base with the player of the match, that being Amin Al-Badari. The Hercules BS player, his goals were important as hell. That award handed by Tobile Sifundo of KZN, head of Department of Sports, Arts and Culture. Well played, Monsieur Amin Al-Badari. Now, confirmation, it was 7-2 Malawi Seychelles, 8-4 Mozambique, Angola in favor of Mozambique. South Africa beaten 3-1 by Saudi Arabia. And then in this one, the Moroccans holding on for a narrow 2-1 win against Tanzania. It is semi-final time on Friday. Make sure you do not miss a beat. 2-1 at full time for this one. Kickoff, join us from 2 o'clock. More sugar moments coming your way.
Congratulations to Morocco and to Tanzania. Congratulations to Morocco. It will be interesting to find the final group standings. Who's playing who, where, when? Safe home. We'll see you tomorrow for those who are going to come for the Legends game.